Welcome to the channel, everyone. I hope you guys are having a great day or morning wherever you guys are in the world. My name is Andre Morgan. Today I'm going to be using Capture One to help with reducing redness in the skin. Before I used to use Lightroom and it was a nightmare. So I'm going to show you how easy it is to get rid of redness in the skin. Here we go. All right. So here we have the picture with the redness in the model's skin right here. And this is the result that we're going to try to achieve. Okay, so let me go quickly through this. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to click on the plus icon, holding down the mouse button, and then click new fill adjustment layer. Once I do that, I scroll down to where you see the graph right here that says skin tone. And then I'm going to click on the dropper right here. And what I basically need to do is I need to find an area of the skin that doesn't have the redness and the skin tone that I really like. I like this area right here, so I'm going to just click on that. And down here on the left hand side right here, you'll see where this is actually the color of the skin. I'm going to click on this to extend the range of colors that I'm going to be using. I'm going to just reduce it from the greens right here just a little. And then now, this is where the magic happens. All I'm going to do now is just slide this hue slider under the uniformity right here. And you can slowly see the skin redness is being reduced. And then now I'm gonna bring up the lightness to a point where I'm happy. I'm gonna increase the saturation just a bit. You can see that there's a little bit of a hint of green in the skin. So all I'm gonna do now, the hue over here, I'm just gonna drag the hue a little bit over to the left to kind of bring back a little bit of that pink into the skin. And then I'm gonna carry the hue over some more, right about there. As you can see, that it has overall changed the color of the image, which I don't want. I want to just apply it alone to the skin. And all I'm gonna do is go back up to the adjustment layer, right click, and then click clear mask. I'm gonna press B on my keyboard. And then all I'm gonna do is increase the size of my brush and just start painting, just like that. And to help to see the areas that I'm actually doing, I'm gonna just press M on the keyboard for the mask. And all I'm gonna do now is just paint so I can be a little bit more precise. I know that the mask kinda touched our eyes right there, which I'm gonna just fix that just a little bit. I'm gonna speed the video up so that we don't take too much time. All right, so that is done. Let me press back. Let me just touch this area right here. As you can see, I went a little bit inside the eye, so I'm gonna press E on the keyboard for the eraser tool, and all I'm gonna do is just remove it from our eyes right there. Like so. I went a little bit over here as well. Let me just right click, and I'm just going to reduce this just a little bit. Okay, good. All right, and then all I do now is just like that. All right, so this is a little bit rough. I'm gonna press M on the keyboard again. And as you can see, guys, we have definitely reduced a significant amount of the redness in the skin. And all I can do now, I can just say, okay, there's a little bit of redness in the forehead right here, a little bit under the neck right here, a little bit on our arm. And all I do the same thing once more. Like so, come back down here, select the good skin that I like so. All right, extend that, and all I'm gonna do is just bring up that hue, bring the lightness once more, just a little bit. I'm gonna bring this back to get a little bit of pink back in the skin, and then all I'm gonna do is go up, right click, and clear. Rinse and repeat, guys. Rinse and repeat. And all I do is just kind of paint away those little areas right there. And there you have it, guys. Look how easy that was. Took us a few minutes just to get rid of the redness in the skin. And this is one of the reasons why I kind of switched over. I haven't switched over fully yet, but I switched over to using Capture One for doing any kind of skin coloring or anything like that in that nature. All right, guys, I hope you guys did enjoy that video. I know it was pretty quick. I hope you guys learned something. If you have, smash that like button, guys. And if you're new to the channel, guys, subscribe for more. All right, guys, take care and be safe. Peace.